Okay, so no intro today, just 10 quick tips, tricks and hacks to make your video edits and color grades in DaVinci Resolve exactly 7.43 times better. And trust me, I did the math, that number is correct. Okay, and first of all, let me show you how parallel and layer nodes work, because I've noticed that it's a bit confusing for beginners. Okay, look, so when you're color grading, you'll be working with serial nodes most of the time. But then you also have parallel and layer nodes, and the key difference between those two is priority. So when you add a parallel node, it looks like this. And you can make adjustments in each node. So for example, white balance in the top one and contrast in the bottom one. And both of these adjustments will be mixed here in the parallel mixer. And if you add another serial node after that mixer, you'll see the result of that mix. But there's no priority between these nodes. But when you add a layer node, everything looks kind of similar, right? And there's also a layer mixer. But you use layer nodes when you want the corrections of one node to have priority over the other ones. So for example, if I make a selection of the skin here and I make it look super orange, right? And then I go to the top one and make everything look super blue, that selection of the skin tones will still look the same, super orange. Because this layer, the bottom one, has priority over the top one. So a lower node always has priority over a higher one. And if I would do the same correction but with parallel nodes, it would look like this. See, the skin tones don't look super orange anymore because there's no priority. All the adjustments done with parallel nodes get mixed together. Now, when working with nodes, not only the order of the color adjustments and color space transforms and things like that is important, also the order of your effects is super important. And I'm gonna show you with a few examples. Let's say you wanna make a shot go slowly out of focus, right? With a blur effect. But you also wanna add some film grain. Well, always put the film grain as the last node because that blur effect shouldn't affect the film grain. When you shoot on actual film and your shot is out of focus, that doesn't affect the film grain. Film grain always looks the same. The focus of the shot doesn't affect it. But also the glow and the halation effect, for example. It's always best to put those after the blur, but before the film grain. So always think about the order of your effect nodes. Effects nodes. Effect nodes? Effects nodes. Okay, when you're working with power windows, you have different options. Circular, linear, and also curve if you want to draw a custom shape. But what if, let's say, you need a window that's almost a circle? A circle with a dent, for example. Well, you can of course draw a custom shape of a circle with a dent, but you can also use a circular window and then go here to options and select convert to Bezier. And now you can add anchor points and just reshape that circle, make it dent. So it makes your power windows even more powerful. Just like how Audio, the sponsor of this video, keeps making their music search features more and more powerful. I use music from Audio all the time for all my videos, and they 100% make it easier to find the perfect song. With Hans AI, you can simply describe what you need with a text prompt and boom, done. And with Link Match AI, which they've recently upgraded, you can simply copy-paste the link to a song and it will search in Audio's entire music library and find songs that sound similar. And you can now even search for music that sounds similar to a specific segment of a reference song. And it will show you in the results which part of the song sounds most similar. And it's all real music from real artists that you can use for personal and client work. So go check them out. The link and discount code are in the description. But maybe wait until after you've finished this video, okay? Okay. Okay, so I've already shared this tip more than a few times already, but I keep getting the question, what if I make a selection of the skin tones with the qualifier tool and Resolve adds colors in the background because they're too close to the color of the skin? Well, all you have to do is make your selection first with the qualifier and then combine the qualifier with a power window or more power windows, see? And of course, you can also track those windows if the subject moves. And then you can target a specific area of the frame. This is something super simple, but I still don't do it enough. Make my own shortcuts. Because look, lots of tools and functions have a shortcut by default, right? And so it's easy to start using them. If you hover over all these tools, for example, in the edit page, you can see that most of them have a shortcut assigned. And you can remap them, of course, if you want. But then lots of other functions and tools don't have shortcuts. But you can assign a shortcut to almost everything. For example, recently I finally assigned shortcuts to the playback resolution settings because I use those all the time now that my computer is starting to struggle. And it's super easy. Go here to keyboard customization, look up what you want to assign a shortcut to, and done. Ever since I discovered stack timelines, I use them for all kinds of stuff. So you can turn on stack timelines here, and it will basically allow you to have multiple timelines in one project. And then when you hit this icon here, you can show them on top of each other, so stacked. And then what you can do, for example, is copy a sequence to the new timeline and make a different edit, change some things to see what works best. And of course, you can do that in one timeline, but then the navigation between the two edits is a lot more annoying and you have to go back and forth all the time. And then when you're done, you can get rid of the extra timelines here, but you'll still have them available here. And like I said, you can use this feature for all kinds of stuff. But did you know that you can also use stack timelines to open a compound clip and then make adjustments to that compound clip? It's super useful. So a compound clip is basically a group of clips, but then unified into one clip. So if I want to turn all these clips, for example, into a compound clip, I just select them, right click, and new compound clip. And it will also appear in the media pool as one clip. But what if you want to make adjustments to the individual clips? Well, you can right click and decompose in place, use clips only, and then you'll see all the individual clips again. But then after you're done, you have to select them all again and create a new compound clip. But if you have stack timelines enabled, you can also right click on the compound clip and select open in timeline. And then it will open your compound clip in a new timeline. You can make your adjustments, close that timeline again, and your adjustments will be saved in the compound clip. Okay, and this is something that I didn't do for the longest time. When you use DaVinci Resolve's built-in animated titles on a 4K timeline, they will automatically be shown in 4K resolution, right? But a lot of third-party plugins and also assets work differently. Sometimes there's a separate version for 1080 and 4K, or like Motion VFX plugins, for example, they have a setting for when you're using the effects on a 4K timeline. And it's usually here in the inspector window all the way at the bottom. So don't forget to check it when you're working on a 4K timeline. And then next, something stupidly simple, but only if you know. If you don't know, you don't know. So if you want to apply effects to a title, for example, lately I've been experimenting with some blur on the sides of my texts and titles. And it looks like this. I think it looks cool. But anyway, how do you do that? Because when you drop a title on the timeline, and you go to the Fusion page, it doesn't show that title. It just shows you the video clip underneath. So you can't apply effects to that title that you just dropped on the timeline. Well, actually you can, but you have to use the text plus title instead of the normal text title. If you use that one and drop it on the timeline, and then go to the Fusion page, voila, now you can see the title and you can apply effects to it. For example, the radial blur. And then finally, something I recently learned from Darren Mostyn's videos. Go check out his channel if you want the expert level color grading. So when you're color grading and you want to match the colors of two images, you can use a still image as the reference image, for example, right? And then enable the split screen. And then here you can make it so that it shows both images entirely instead of just half and half. And also in the waveform, you'll see the information for both images then. So this is the left image, this is the right image. Super handy for when you're matching colors. But did you know that it also shows both images in the vector scope? I didn't know that. But they're just on top of each other. Look, if I make a crazy adjustment, you'll see that in the vector scope, both images are laid on top of each other. And so this can also be super handy when matching colors. You just have to know it. And that's it, another collection of quick tips, tricks, and hacks. I hope at least some of them are useful. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.